Alright. Looks like we are live. Let's get the screen pulled up here. There we go. I'm gonna do a solid color fill. Where do we want to start tonight? I'm gonna go dark with some saturation, or we're gonna go light. Let's go light. Going on the light side. Okay, let me get my reference board pulled up. I've just got the usual random airplanes pulled up, but I don't know that we'll do airplanes tonight. Just would like to have something, you know, to think about the forms and colors and that sort of thing. All right, well, let's do something, huh? My apologies for starting this hour late. But no one knows the time or the hour, as they say. As the good book says. Pretty sure it's not talking about this live stream, but one can dream. Let's see here. Let's zoom out a little bit. I think I'm just going to play with unlocking forms. You know, I was tempted to start trying to make something symmetrical. There's a there's an artist who does these really fun sketches. I think the name is Brian Richards. Don't recall, but anyway, so what I'll do, it's a neat idea, you know, just start with kind of a swiggle, right? I'm going for like, let's go for some interesting forms here, and I can kind of see him doing some repetition here, so I want to be careful. But then what you do is you take something like this and you go, okay, what if this was, say, wrapping around a form? And then let's make it symmetrical, right? So it's a neat little exercise. And then I'm going to build, you know, build a little face out of this. Alien face, of course. I hope this is not what most faces look like. but yeah, you can take this method, start to play with it. I'm gonna build out these forms. Let's clean that up a little bit there. And then I think in combination, you can use this method with, it's kind of like these lost shapes, or like a, there's a, it's almost like a Rorschach test, if you're familiar with that, where you, you know, you draw, you've got an ink blot or something, and you've got to kind of figure out, you know, what's going on in that shape, right? And so we're just starting by kind of laying things in, and then we're going to build off of that. Like, you know, what does this, what do we see in here? And then you just start pulling it out. Pull out the things that you see. Build it up. Don't like it? Get rid of it. And then carry on. I do think that there's a certain amount of efficiency, stroke economy that this method can lose if you slow down too much. So I'm gonna try to just, I'm actually gonna zoom in a little bit so that I'm taking larger strokes with my whole shoulder and not just my wrist and elbow. And you can see already I'm starting to follow some of those forms that I had already brought in. But you know what, instead, let's just see if we can find some rhythms in here. And generally speaking, when it comes to the painting side, not necessarily drawing, you want to have as large of a brush as possible. This is my school of thought, at least. You know, I'm not saying that I'm not laying claim to it, but I'm saying it is the one that I subscribe to. And the reason being is that you tend to take stronger, more confident strokes that way. See, if I'm kind of, I'm trying to build up this edge here and I just kind of come in slowly like that, it's going to have all these hash marks and so forth. And there are methods for that. But if I just do this with one stroke, I just get one brush that's big enough to do the job, it's just so much cleaner. Suppose I want to go the other direction, you know, like so. And so anyway, that's what you might call stroke economy. Or brush economy. Just trying to keep it clean and simple. So like this in here, you can see those kind of jagged marks. Probably not going to help us. Okay? In the long run, we're probably going to end up cleaning those up. But if we consider some of these forms here, try to hit them in a simplified way. Then it should end up ultimately being cleaner design. All right, let's zoom back out. Eric, what in the ever-living heck are you talking about? None of this looks very clean to me. You've lost your mind. Well, you might not be wrong, but something might emerge. All right, this sort of thing here. Almost, these are, you know, very similar kind of motifs going on there. What if we try to bridge these together somehow? Oh, we're having that pressure sensitivity fun again. Not that bad today, but there's every couple of strokes goes haywire. I promise you I'm not going to complain as much as last time. All right, we got Adonis in the chat. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Yeah, I was thinking about you. We didn't catch up on Discord to have a look at your latest work. So if you're interested in doing that, just hit me up sometime on Discord and we'll set up a time. I met with another artist friend of mine, Morris, yesterday, kind of going through some of his stuff, and it's great, it's fun. And I gotta say, Morris's style, I've always liked and appreciated what he's doing. He's after something. After something that may be a little hard to define, but it's really his own, and I think that's cool. Right here. I want to be a little bit careful here that I'm not using the same brush size all the time here. This is like, some kind of goofy cat looking thing there. Whoops. Let's go full screen. No, halfsies. So in search of rhythms over here, we found nothing. Came up lacking. Man, what is this guy even doing? I feel like every form that I play with here ends up being, to me, like it wants to be in the Predator vein. You know? I don't know. Bring these in here. Or like a Zerg or something. Always liked the Zerg. All right, this thing. Do you have any potential that we must explore? I think this up here is kind of boring, but you can turn it into something. Let's see. I'm looking at the chat. Gabe Heisinger. Excited to see where this one goes. Yeah, this will be fun. I always gotta temper my expectations, but I think at some point, you know, ideas start to emerge. And it's fun. Thanks for joining in tonight. We've got we got the sketch group tomorrow, by the way. Can get in touch with Emmy or Joelle about that. And tomorrow is Adonis's birthday. Happy birthday. Hope it's a good one. Do you have any big plans? You got a patron who will get you a Cintiq for your birthday. That's a plan. All right, this silly little cat face up here, as much as I enjoy it, we're gonna push that one out. Sorry. Should we just keep it as one smooth curve, yeah, like so, or see, that's what I was talking about with scratchy, kind of making scratchy lines. It's not that appealing. Better to kind of have an idea of what exactly you want to be there. Make as big of a brush as possible and lay it in. So what I was asking here is, what if we go down and up? You know, so I think like a knight's helmet, you get the crown is up here, you know, where the cranium would be, and then this visor kind of comes out like so. So it would be like whoop. And whoop. Know what I mean? Okay, I'm gonna keep working on this alien here because I was kind of having fun with it. The only real caveat being, at some point, We're gonna have to work out this pose and anatomy, foreshortening, you know, all the fun stuff. But I'm thinking we got this dude. We have an opportunity to make some fun, you know, armor bits or whatever. Maybe he's got a backpack, or maybe he's got a rocket pack. You know? There we go. I'm just... Sorry, other drawing over there. You're no longer there anymore. Okay, we'll just... Kind of build up that intensity there with some contrast. And then this, I did a up and over, you know, this is like a, you know, cloth type thing. But I think I want to clean this up and, well, maybe even give it, I don't know, maybe more of a, I don't know if I want more of a ripple to it, or the cleanness makes it look, you know, like, like if he's jumped up and it's coming back down, you know, then it's got this kind of like rhythm to it. But if he's got this jetpack and it's just, it's just forcing air all over the place, you know, it should have this kind of crazy, seems like it should have this crazy ripple. We still need to probably clean it up, make it, you know, stylized in a way. Like, it's gotta be, it's gotta be easy for the eye to follow. I don't know. Anyway. Alright, let's do this leg here. It's funny, I don't know at this point. You know, can you even see what it is that I'm trying to pull out? Because I see it. I see this little face up here. This little Star Warsy alien type dude. And his torso's kind of turned in like this. Right? And then his leg is kicking out over here. Other leg. Other legs down here. What do we want? We want the bottom of the foot. You know, so his foot comes up and over like that. It's a rough foot. Whew. But let's see. Clean it up a little bit here. I'm like tempted to put the little like Quaker buckle on there. Cause that's what space aliens like. That is their jam. Their Quaker jam. Actually, that sounds delicious. Quaker jam. best part of waking up. Mediocre way to start your day. Okay. Don't overthink it, Eric. Don't overthink it. We're not even to the rendering stage here. We're just... This is blocking. We're thinking here. Looking at the chat. Unless I have class during sketch group, otherwise I'd be there every week. Well, let Emmy know, because we've been talking about maybe doing a different time. And you might be able to catch the end of it. Adonis asks, what time are you planning on doing the sketch group? So the sketch group is a local thing in town. And that's 3 o'clock. Another artist friend of mine hosts it. And, something we started a while ago just to force the, the discipline of showing up and drawing something. You know, there was really nothing to it other than, you had to draw. That was the only rule. Didn't matter whether it was digital, whether it was for class, whether it was representational, or abstract, goofy, cartoon, whatever, no one cared. Point was, show up and draw. And then, the side benefit of that, of course, is the community that you get with other artists and conversation. And the biggest thing just being work those art muscles, do the thing, and have some accountability, I guess, to have other artists push you along. Okay, so then I want this to kind of ripple, start to ripple as it gets down a little farther. Maybe it's, it's hitting the ground. And then we get this effect here. I'm not much of an inker, those comic book masters, they got it. They got it figured out. I should read a book or something. Learn from someone who has been doing this for a long time. The mediocre way to start your day is Folgers at your face, by the way. I didn't know if you picked up the reference. See, back in the golden age of television, the 90s, we had all these jingles. Every product had a song, an audio logo, if you will. And they work, I'll tell you what. Get stuck in your head. Dr. Pepper, it's a part of me. But the thing is, you know, I didn't think they really could anticipate where things were going, you know, because now, literally, Dr. Pepper is a part of me. And that's not a positive thing. I don't like the thought of that. So, well, it was good while it lasted, I guess, that campaign. And then what was Folgers was, the best part of waking up is Folgers in your cup. But then you find out that that is definitely not the case. And if you told me there was Folgers to try to get me out of bed, that would not be effective. I'm just throwing that out there. I'd probably just say, maybe we'll wake up and we'll get out of bed tomorrow. That'll give you enough time to get to the store and get a decent brand of coffee. What am I even doing? I'm just like noodling with this shape back here, and that is not necessary. Not necessary in the least. Anywho, big idea. He's got a rocket pack. It's doing rocket pack stuff. We'll get it worked out. All right, I'm going to darken a little bit around all that so that the light can kind of push forward. Come through. I don't know what I'm doing with his other arm. He doesn't necessarily need another arm, and that's something to think about. Like, we always want to decide, you know, what's going on with, you know, this part of the body or that. You know, it's like you draw the face and you got to have both eyes, and it's like, well, maybe from that angle you actually wouldn't see both eyes. And so anyway, that's just something to think about. And so we'll be thinking about that. It's like, you know, do we need to have a hand with a blaster, you know, like pew pew when he's all left-handed for some reason? Or can we just obscure, you know, like it's behind here, you know, like the pose is like this and the arm goes, you know, back down behind and you don't see the whole thing, you know? Who knows? Maybe that's none of our business. Maybe we should just leave this guy alone. Maybe we shouldn't. Maybe we should keep a close eye on him. Maybe he's dangerous, you know? I don't know. Maybe I should make up my mind. Alright, I don't like that. I like how this arm kind of swings up. I want to maybe clean this up just a little bit here. And I don't like how that's like tangent there. I might want to lift the arm up just a little bit. Like the shoulder here. Let's see. This comes down to the trapezius shoulder. And then we'll just kind of put something back here to work that shape out. Yeah, so that we're popping this shoulder forward. See what I'm saying? Maybe, I don't know. Maybe not. Foreshortening. Sorry, it worked. Where is Manny Gomez when you need him? What would Manny do? Alright, so do I want to bring this arm? So here's our hand, right? And then we get this foreshortened. And then we get the elbow right about here-ish. Bring that arm down. But all of that, to me, just feels a little bit off. Okay, and part of that, I think, is bringing the shoulder into the chest. Right, so that this is all one kind of unit there. But then part of it too is just the foreshortening. Like, I don't know that we need to show that much of the arm. So if this is coming in like that, and here's, and then our elbow is like right here. So then, you know, maybe that comes across a little tighter. I don't know, maybe we can even come up and bring this over, you know. And there's like this random knight looking at him, and then there's like this little critter over here. Now it's like an undead polar bear. Something. All right, I think we need to zone out some different regions. So, like, if this, I don't know, his pant legs are dark. I think his boots dark, maybe. And then, I don't really know what's going on here. Should this be all in shadow? It's kind of a boring shadow. Push it all that away. Should maybe this portion up here, should this be brighter? No. Because if I were a bounty hunter, I would want to be easily recognizable. You know, the kind of camouflage that makes you stand out. Boring cloth stuff. And let's do a form change here. Some kind of a, I don't know, satchel-y thing. Some equipment on a belt. And then we've this some kind of material I can stretch. Cause you're gonna need that. When you're, you know, doing bounty hunter stuff. In space. And whatnot. This shape figured out here. So, you know, this is one of those things where, you know, drawing ahead of time would have been like an awesome idea. So that you've already decided, like, oh yeah, no, he's got a, hips are pointed this way, shoulders are pointed that way, all that good stuff, you know. None of this crazy winging it stuff. stuff. Terrible advice from this guy. Terrible. Never wing it. You totally can, though. Let's clean this up a little bit. I think that... I don't know. It's kind of an extreme foreshortening there. But... But it's also like kind of an extreme angle. What am I even saying? Extreme foreshortening, extreme angle. I think what I'm trying to say, if I could interpret for this guy, I don't know. It's not making a lot of sense right now. Is that it's both the camera and the angle of that hand. Like I've got this hand just it's kind of massive, right? It's like hands always get tricky. I like to block them in, like they always seem to work on the block in. And then once I actually start, like, sorting them out, then it's like, oh boy, this actually has to make sense. You know? Who knows? Who can know? Manny Gomez knows. If he shows up, he'll tell me what's what. I just gotta decide what he's doing with that hand. I've got him like, so I kind of want it like he's jumping up that jetpack and the hand is kind of half relaxed, you know, but then I want that pointer finger . That does not look right at all. He's like, hey, look over there. That's where I'm going. That's it. That's the place. Now that I've completely jacked up his hand, let's see if we can rebuild it. Oh, that's lame. Yeah, that's pretty lame. Not very good on the foreshortening. Excuse me. I think it would make sense to get some reference for that. And I'm going to open up these fingers a little more here. I don't like how I don't even know. All right, we'll just go with that. Let's move on. We're gonna go with super bright knee pads because that is the coolest thing. Let's just simplify that form. He's always got to have some kind of like a a knife or a side pouch, something here, you know. You can have at the ready. I don't like that dark line on top there. Just going for something that will give that like a, I don't know, like a, just a different material on the end. You know, if that truly is a knife in there, then you're going to want something reliable to keep you from getting poked. I don't know, just seems logical. just thinking, do we want more kind of cloth elements flying up and around, little cape thingamajiggy? Yeah. I mean, why not have a jetpack and a cape? Seems totally reasonable. Actually, I think I preferred that being just a clean value back there, but let's see where this goes. Let's bring that back down. Cool shoes, dude. Said the artist facetiously. See, could have just left it at the compliment. Didn't have to ruin this guy's day. I mean, it just keeps getting worse and worse with every brushstroke. So one thing to consider when you're doing these things, especially painting, drawing and painting really, but you gotta consider, what does it mean? Like, what does this stroke, shadow, not shadow, dark mark, light mark, what does it mean? In terms of the message that I'm attempting to convey visually. So, you know, here, is this white mark there, is that a a part of his boot, or is that a part of the background? Okay, so if it's like a little, I don't know, weird shield thing on his boot, we could do that. He's got his space cowboy boots. I just like didn't even bother to tie him up today, you know. I think sometimes you can leave things ambiguous. You know, have it be a lost edge, whatever. But I think to a degree, you know, you can mislead with that inadvertently. So you want to think about how will this be perceived. Like if I put an edge here, so suppose I wanted to like separate this leg in the foreground to the stuff in the background. So I could push all this back, make it lighter, and then, you know, make an edge there. Like so. Right, so that's one way. Or you could do a, you know, black turn of the form, stroke, however you want to term that, right? You could do the direction of the lines, you know, so you could have, you know, the torso coming like this and this leg coming like that. And even just the size of the lines, you know, so if we make these ones smaller back here, I'm gonna make them closer together, you know. Or you could do rim light. You know, vary up the thickness of that to kind of show a form. Now the thing with all these though is you're making a decision about what that describes, right? And, you know, one of the things I like about just kind of working out of the abstract soup is that you can kind of push and pull things and kind of like that Rorschach test type thing, like you just kind of like let it describe its own forms and effects, and then you can respond to that, right? And you kind of let it drive the composition in a way. Now, at some point, though, you got to start cleaning it up and figure out what's what. So I don't know that a white or a bright form behind his bright head is a good idea. So if we, you know, think of his head as one shape that we want to kind of highlight as that's a focal point, right? So we can kind of push all this stuff back behind him. Maybe bring this collar down in value. give that some form. Bring it a little higher so that they power of suggestion, that those associated shapes kind of suggest that this that this here and this over here are the same or similar things. Now with this, I think we could do maybe a core shadow. Okay, bring it down just a little bit. Yeah, it'd be kind of interesting, maybe have this side be just a little bit darker than the background. Have the background kind of switch, you know, from this side to that side. Switching background. What in the world is this man talking about? I don't think he knows. All right, I'm going to step away from that for a little bit. We'll maybe develop some of these other things here. Not that these are really any better, but instead of just kind of staring at this thing endlessly, let something else do the driving for a minute. Don't think we need the white eyes on those. Always has an effect if you have a dark eye socket with a light eye. It's always just very, very creepy. There's also, I think, something unsettling about a, you know, completely black eye. You know, there's no whites in the eye. But I will say, you know, even though, you know, that was something that I think I kind of figured out pretty early on, but just because you can make like a monster that's kind of unsettling, I mean, that's, let me put it this way. Unsettling can be interesting and have its own appeal. But it is also kind of low-hanging fruit. I think that there's an initial challenge in getting, you know, monsters or unsettling things not to look dorky. Is that the right word? Like, you know, look at some old movies. You can see, you'll see some monster setups, masks, motifs that just didn't quite hit. And if they don't quite land, then they kind of make you giggle, you know? And that's not what you want. You don't want a monster that, like, pops out of the corner and you go, okay, that's it. Nice try, you know. But that being said, there are some motifs, I'll say low-hanging fruit, that not too hard to land at. Land on, at, around, arrive at the location. I think that's what I mean. Yeah, we could do a counter change on this one here, where the ear comes up behind, and it's a dark ear. This one. All right, now this night. Let's go. Maybe around here. We've got this, that little corner there implies a form change. And so let's exploit that. Armor is always a blast because you get to deal with contrast and you know, metal is, it can be a little tricky, but it's also kind of forgiving because as long as you have, like, some contrast from one form change to the next, it really just kind of implies reflection, right? And so, the change in form The change in form is visualized by just like a alternate value, light or dark, right? So like here, you know, we could have this, what do they call those things? The round part that goes on the, kind of covers the latches on the shoulder pauldrons. It's like this little round thing with like a spike on it. You know, hitch in the face spike. So anyway, with this, so suppose I wanted to invert this. You totally could. So you just go light on the bottom, dark on the top. And then we take the metal on the shoulder and we just go light at the form change. And as long as you switch it at some point, you know, so it goes dark, maybe it goes dark back here. You can get away with a lot. So let's invert that again. Suppose we go dark here, and then light on the backside. And generally with metal, you know, you're thinking reflection. So you're thinking like there's a main light that's hitting it. Like say this is the main light there, and then you need like a core shadow and like a bounce light. You know, it's getting a reflection off of some other surface, you know. But it's very forgiving with the fact that you are reflecting light all the time with this, right? So like here, if I really want this dark, you know, that cutout there for the visor to show, I can bring this value up here, no problemo. In fact, let me do it with a larger brush, follow the principle that I was talking about earlier. So, you know, we could do that as a clean, well, that's like a lost edge. And we could do this, like as a lost edge there. That'd be kind of fun. Did I say lost edge? What am I even saying? That's a pretty sharp edge there. I was going for counter change here to have this go from like a bright this bright plume up here to do the dark side back there. Oh, what is this guy even talking about? It's never making any sense. Not a lick of sense. Now it looks like this is his arm over here. We gotta have the, what do they call those things? It's been a long time since I've done any, work. I forget what all these things are called, but that little these fins on the shoulders, or on the, did I say shoulders? Elbows. That they, again, they kind of cover the joint, but I think they were also, if I remember correctly, they were kind of sharp. Tended to be nasty. And so now let's go up. We'll kind of follow that form of the forearm and put some flutes into that armor. And then we'll do like what do they call that? Plated mail, you know, for the hand. I can't remember what the name is. Basically, it has the overlapping plates that articulate. Overlapping, articulating plates. That's definitely overcomplicated right there. I think this needs to be bent over. See, that's his left arm. Should we put a sword in there somewhere? In here. He's got his arm up over there. Now it's a battle between a medieval knight and space bounty hunter from a long time ago. Far away place. Real long ago. Alright, so we go. Then we'll just do the knuckles. Yeah, we'll leave that in there. Whole leg. I mean, for one, that whole hip is like, how long? Goodness. I mean, this leg should be, you know, the knee might be like right there. Ah, he's one of those aliens with those super long knees. Super long thighs. Works out, does a lot of squats. That's how that works, right? You work out, your legs get longer. Misinformation channel, what in the world? Okay, let's see. Nah, that's not helping. It's just there. Now his head looks giant. They both have big heads. Yeah, we'll leave it. I think I'll diminish the size of that back a little bit. We'll leave this a little bit larger so that he's got... Got some scale to work with. See, there we go with the scratchy marks, right? Just gotta pick a spot. And execute on it. In my opinion. Yeah, I think we need something more like that. That's funny that that line went tangent with this here. I think this whole guy right here, I mean, he's okay and everything, but I'm gonna rotate him. Actually, there we go. Done. All right, yeah, I'm thinking something like that. Be like the Zerg, you know, escaping the flamethrower. That was one of the cool StarCraft weapons, was the flamethrower. At least against like little Zerglings or whatever. Should we just bring that to a point, or should we combine those? No. Life's greatest questions. To homogenize or not to homogenize? Oh, this would be a fun opportunity to put some, smudge brushing. Everyone loves smudge brushing. There's always one. Not me. I don't like it. I don't like it at all. I'm offended. Yep. Well, smudges. Smudge brushes have that effect on you. From time to time. Man, what is this man talking about? It's not making a lot of sense anymore. I'm just going to see if we can kind of gently work in, you know, a gradation towards this foreground. These obviously not so gentle, but from here to here, kind of grade that in. Whoops, a daisy there. Alright, let's make sure we don't distract too much from the, you know, the rocket pack. That's the big deal, right? Is the bread machine just beeping away? It's a wonderful thing. Bread machines. That may actually be the best part of waking up. But unfortunately, it didn't make a very great jingle. You know, for a song. The best part of waking up is carbohydrates. Like, I don't like that going all super dark there. I do want to darken it up a little bit so that we can, so that we have somewhere to go to push that, this value to be the brightest. Should we put a rim light on these since they're being lit by that? I really haven't done anything with that head. Look at that goofy looking head. I'm sorry. I said that in anger. Should we up the contrast on that? That's getting goofier. Let's go all the way right. Get our brightest values in there. That bread's about freaking out now. It's like, hey, seriously though. Should this just be one simplified shape instead of trying to have all these crazy shapes and angles and whatnot? Just make it, just fill it in, just make it all bright. And is there a second booster on the other side there? Do we even need to explain any of that? I don't think so. And then this angry dog over here will be like, he's not important though. He's got a, sorry, dog. Yeah, I don't like that because the seam is like higher up. It's up in here. I don't know. I want to have a little bit of that stretch, but without going, you know, crazy on it. Yeah, this head is silly. I like it. You know, kind of like the goofiness of it, but it is silly. Go more hammerhead like. Maybe. Could return to that motif of the dark eye, light eye, dark eye socket. What am I saying? We've got a knight fighting a space alien. We don't have to do anything, right? We can do whatever we want. Alright, now I think we just need to hide some more things in the background here. You know? Little Zerg. Zerg down here. Or something. Not the best Zerg. But we'll count it. You know, dog, doggo, right here. Well, you know, I don't know if I've ever said this on the live stream, but I do have a default drawing, and I don't mean the circle. That's start a lot of drawings that way, but. I mean, there's a drawing that if I don't know what to draw, it's my go-to. You ready? It's somebody slipping and dropping a pizza. There's our pizza. Here's the box. You get the arc. You get the square forms. You get the cast shadow. Let's go. Put that right there. See. There's a method to the madness. And you gotta get the texture on there. You know, pepperonis. And you gotta have the person slipping. One of them falling this way. Dropping the box. Reaching up like this. Oh. Oh no. Let's see. Let's see if we can ruin another, butcher another hand tonight, but here we go. We'll go. That's more or less what I want there. I'm telling you, when in doubt, drop a pizza box because it's a dynamic drawing. Okay, that's it. I'm not going to try to justify this idea anymore. It just is what it is. And, let's see, you got to get the look of despair, too. No. And then maybe we cast a shadow on his face there. On a coffee drink, that's another good one. Let's do like a let's see how would it splash. So if this is getting pushed away this way, then we got this kind of Red Machine beckons. Doesn't like being ignored. Okay, so we get this. Liberty. Thing is, yeah, what is the thing? The thing is, you want to have this, I think, this kind of combined shape. You know, so it looks like everything kind of is all attached together. Also has the kind of the flow of, so like if this, say this kind of wraps around like that, so then we want all of those to appear as though they're all coming off of the same motion. Okay, let's lighten this up, shall we? This will be like whatever coffee brand right there. Bring the band around the cup. Get that light there. Fix that ellipse. You gotta have the lid somewhere too, right? You would think. All right, do we want to brighten up? So, first of all, I think we darken this up. We get a little shadow there from our coffee. And then we got to kind of put a little fluid edge on this, catching the highlight. All right, and then maybe we poke some holes through it. And then maybe give it a little little bit of motion. So it's not completely freeze frame. And then maybe we have it just be a little bit translucent in there. It's too bad that leg is like 10 feet long. You know? It could have been cool. Should we increase the contrast a bit? That shoe is gonna be the end of me. Yeah. Don't feel like it's that difficult of a pose, but golly. Can't seem to nail it down. Let's get this shadow on that blade. Oh no, I just said shadow blade. What time is it? 1, 2, 3, 4 a.m. That's my sign. I think it's time to close up shop here. But it's been real. Let's see. Push that back a little bit, but I do like the idea. Just to give it a little something instead of that dark line there. Okay, anyway. It's probably a good place to stop. Good of a place as any. I don't know. Should we put a little bit of a reflected light down in here? Just to give this a little more form. All right, I think we'll call it there. I don't know what this is about. Doesn't really matter. But it was fun. It's fun. I might go, might check our curves, kind of see where we're at. Go a little bit. I don't think we really need to go brighter. We do have quite a bit of dark values in there. You know, of course we could pump the contrast, but it kind of makes sense to kind of keep things in their value zones. Right. I don't know. That does it a little bit, but I think only in certain areas where I really like it. So, like, I might knock it out there, here, 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 the blaster, there, the rocket. It's super cool. The coffee. Okay, and then we're going to invert it. So, that should just give us just a little bit of a bump. Just in a few of these areas. Yeah, it's funny because I don't even know what's better, if any. I think it kind of flattens things out a little bit. But, okay, anyway. And then sometimes it's nice to add a little, bring in a little color. And I promise you, we are going to stop early this time. Not gonna just keep going and going forever. Because I haven't even got that in me. I'm just gonna stop right there. Right there. See? Just a itsy bitsy little bit of something. Maybe we'll go color. I think I like that. Okay. What in the world is this all about? None can know. Vivid light, that's fun. I thought you said we were not going to be playing with this forever. Well, I did say that. Yeah, I don't know. I don't even know. Whoops, that's the color balance. I want to do this guy here. Let's leave that. Maybe a gun. I don't know. Maybe the Zerg. Maybe the coffee. It's hard to say. All these things are so important. The pizza. Let's do Oh man, I'm doing it. I'm getting sucked into the hole. Into the trap. Don't let it happen. Oh, goodness. Alright. I want to go to the levels of this mask and just knock out the floor a little bit there. I guess we have to do another color balance. We just have to. It's not really leaving us much of a choice. It's a tough call because I like it. I like it a lot, but I think ultimately I just want this to be like color. But in order to do that, see if I set that to color, I'm not going to do all the wonderful things that Vivid Light does, which will do pass through. Yeah, I think at the end of the day, I gotta go a little subtle with this. Maybe this will be color. Luminosity, color. Normal. Color. I think I'm going to split that channel out. I don't even know anymore. I don't even know. What do I try? You know? I don't even know what I'm doing. I think I gotta stop. This is fun, but I gotta stop. Okay, well, yeah, I think that's gonna do it for tonight. So, okay, we'll go there. Let's go full screensies. And I better go get that bread. Okay, so that is it for tonight. I guess I'll try to be on time next week. We had the special late night edition. Did the 9 o'clock live stream at 10:30. So my apologies. But like I said, it's unpredictable these days. Actually, you know, I was putting my my 4-year-old to bed, and I was reading him a story, and I lulled myself to sleep. So, that's the story. It was one of those tactile books, you know, with like the textures in it, farm animals and fences and tractors and stuff. Scratch and sniff, you know. I don't know, one of those things. One of those books that's got the tactile thing going on. Anyway, whenever I read the children's books, I have to like amp up the voices, you know, and do silly things. And I guess they just tuckered me right out and I fell asleep. So anyway, that is it for tonight. Thank you for joining in, and we should be back at this next week. And then I think we've got Thanksgiving after that, so we'll see what's going on for that. All right, hopefully you enjoyed the ride, and we're working on your own projects and got some headway on that. And we'll see you again next week. All right, have a good night.